Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Ninja Gaiden Sigma. I'm Serious JG. Didn't have that tea yet. Figure I'll do one more video first because I feel like we could be close to getting to a point where I could potentially sip tea while playing the game off screen to get our monies back. I'm just addicted to it now. Like, it's actually kind of enjoyable to be playing the game and listening to something else. It is actually a fun game to play, don't get me wrong. But, we gotta get out of this underground kooky place that we're at. This is so kooky. This looks just like a simple stone platform, but given the height of the chamber, it is possible that it's some sort of elevator. Right now, however, it shows no sign of moving. I kind of thought this was what we needed to do. Yeah, I was under the impression actually this was gonna be it. Alright, so never mind. I thought that this was how we'd advance. Based on the not that great amount of text that was between us and the next big thing in the fact I was looking at, I figured we'd just go into that room and immediately advance. Okay, so that's it instead. Maybe later that elevator will work. We have to do something. Oh, we're back in the monastery. Oh, I'm under attack. So I do feel a sort of desire to attempt to kill them with the incendiary shuriken, but probably not. That door is unlocked. But while we're in here, on the last page, there's a hastily scribbled message. I cannot believe that someone has opened the safe. The Book of the Aeons I had received from the Emperor himself was stolen. In order to prevent this from ever happening again, I shall change the combination. The date of my daughter's birthday should suffice. At the end of the message, there are notes reading right, left, right, left. Aren't you going to tell us what your daughter's birthday is? Oh, a message found on one of the previous pages. On the 14th day of the 10th month, my beloved daughter's birthday. Okay, she just has to read it to us. So, 14:10. Right, left, 14:10. This guy really is not practicing good OPSEC. And it's life of the gods. Not the thousand gods, just the gods. So we've got another cycle of nine lives of the gods started here. to be careful not to accidentally use Jewel of the Demon Seal until we've checked out other sweet magics. At some point, we got to try out this freezing Ninpo on screen, but.
This place reeks with the stench of a powerful fiend.
Well,
do not
you know,
let it overcome you, and be careful.
Oh, okay, so she's basically warning us that I... And the sound was too low for me to really be able to hear it and quip, but when she said it was the stench of a powerful fiend, I meant to say something like, oh, that's me, sorry. Need to take a bath, but I couldn't, so forget. I failed to defend the base and quip. We already did a fiend challenge around here, so there's probably not a whole lot left. Suddenly I have no control whatsoever over the camera, that's odd. Guessing I shouldn't have been in quite as big a hurry to use up all these items if I'd been thinking about the fact that I would be coming back here. There were cases where I just used a little bit of healing just so that I didn't feel like I lost. There's this treasure chest over there that I had to use. It's probably got like devil way or something. This place reeks of a fiend. Let's go to the altar and trigger a cinematic. Okay, that's pretty much where there's going to be a cinematic, is the altar. Uh-oh. Ooh, she's got demon boobs. And soft serve hair. Gonna have some dialogue with this, She does not look like her sister. Oh! Ouch! Getting hit kind of a lot here, and I'm also thinking of switching to my other sword. So I'm thinking we need to be doing that flying attack, which I can occasionally get there. Right here. Trying to do that. Dive towards your opponent's air move. But I feel like probably hanging around here for a long time is going to be bad for my health. Probably need to stop getting hit with that. Attack is bad. It is very bad. I'm definitely going to need that off-screen that I mentioned to make up using all these freaking items. That diving attack is my main thing that I think I'm supposed to be doing. It's just not... Man, I got her confused for a second. There we go. Jeez. Again, a lot of healing items used. I feel like I just kind of survived rather than really thrived. So, again, I think that's supposed to be Rachel's sister, Alma. And not identical twins, but maybe it's not supposed to be her. She's not really talking that much. Oh, yeah, it probably is supposed to be her, hence the dramatic. Let me help you, sis. And then she turns on Ryu and kills him. Well, these did have the sweetest demon eyes. How could she not be dead? Her brains are completely cut open and exposed. Oh, Rachel. You're a big softy, aren't you?
I couldn't do it.
You could still do it.
I can't kill my own sister.
Well, then let me take care of it. I'm only fighting her because she attacked me. Going after Doku. Hey, he's my target. I don't really care about your sister. Sorry. Seems like family business. I really don't feel like it's my place to interfere, but... So, yeah, healing items used, but we got it done. What's my score gonna be? Lesser Ninja, probably? Or maybe just Grand Ninja? Oh, Master Ninja! Master Ninja theme song. And there was no off-screening. You saw 100% of it, so I somehow managed to get Master Ninja anyway. I guess just from not using Ninpo. So, on screen at some point before this video is over, I'll use the Freezy Freeze Ninpo just to use it.
Internal Affairs National Security Forces. The Duoko Monastery has been attacked and has suffered extreme damage.
What is that city in Missouri? Is that like Franklin? It's Franklin Police Force, folks.
High command. This is a code orange situation. Set up a curfew for all civilians. Request available information on the target.
Request available information on the target. Everyone, go door to door asking anyone for information they might have on our target. So they had no problem with Rachel, but Ryu is a big deal.
So, the greater fiends have a soul, don't they?
Yes, mm-hmm. They are the ones who retain a spirit even after
becoming
fiends. Of course,
big bottom woman, you got no soul.
There are only three of them. Doku, my sister, and another who guards the Emperor.
Another? You mean Leia Skywalker?
It's not safe for you to be around me. You should go now.
Ryu, that is the gayest thing any man has ever said. She's totally into you, and just like, it's not safe you'd be around me. I'm a dangerous loner, and a shonen, if you could only see under the mask.
Ah, Rachel.
Dad!
I should kill you now for the pain you've inflicted on Alma.
But I'd rather turn you into
a poison. I should use you to make her even stronger.
Oh, hey, it's this guy! Who's so chatty?
The cursed blood of a twin sister that shall serve to awaken Alma.
Were you picked a bad time to leave.
Such a fine specimen has to go to waste. You might have become more powerful than even Alma, but no longer.
You know, now that I think about it, you probably could be more powerful than Alma. I should, like, use you instead of reviving Alma, but, yeah, whatever. Oh, come on! This game. It's like she gets slapped to the ground in this, like, act of complete, I'm blanking on the term for, it's not misogynistic slap, and then boob jiggle. Jesus Christ. This game's like female gamers. There's no such thing. Why would we want to appeal to female gamers? I mean, you can, in theory. You can put a character like Rachel, make her not quite as overtly, you know, jack-off fodder for teens, and have her winning her own battles occasionally and standing up for herself and appeal to female gamers. But no! They're just like, she shows up, she talks tough, she gets slapped around, and when she's slapped around, her boobs jiggle. Also, how bad is Ryu's timing? Like, he walks away, and within seconds, the guy he's looking for, because that was Doku, right? Yeah, the guy he's looking for shows up, slaps around his only ally, other than Ayane, who I believe may have disappeared for the rest of the game, other than occasionally telling you, there's a fan coming, look out, or, wall spring. So where the hell is Ryu going now? He's like, he's basically just completely missed the guy he's trying to fight. It's kind of like, and I remember somebody praising this about a game that I might get around to LPing one of these days, possibly. And now I'm blanking on the name. It's that Xbox 360 RPG written by like one of the guys who's a founder of the Final Fantasy series, where your character, like most of your main party characters, are people who had infinite lifespans, but finite capacity for memory, so they don't remember their own pasts. But that game has a villain who just shows up. He's in every freaking scene. Like, the final boss that you fight is constantly there, like, being a pain in your ass. And your characters never quite get the opportunity to fight him until the end. It's not like you fight him 8 times over the course of the game either. But yeah, it's like that. It's like this Doku guy's like, he's just waiting for Ryu to leave, and then casually walks out and it's like, hey, Rachel. Slap. The battle with Rachel's sister, the greater fiend Alma, so at least we've confirmed that, ended without a victor. What? How do you mean? So she's not dead? Ryu really did just, like, wound her, leave her for Rachel to finish, and then when Rachel didn't finish her, Ryu just wandered off? Like, I didn't see what happened to the, like, thoroughly defeated body of Alma. Rachel just kind of talks about how she couldn't kill her. I guess they left the room to have their little chat? However, the aftermath of the battle has caused the Vigor army to be deployed. Fair enough. Oh, Ayane is still here.
Tyron is now under alert. Mm-hmm. You are completely surrounded, and the situation is grave. But you should be able to disrupt the military's organization by attacking the radio control tower next to the military.
You also cut
base.
Them off from the to Robin Williams radio show, the where he's like zany and doesn't play by the rules that the army set for him. Well, maybe I don't want to do that. You ever think of that? Huh? In fact, there is a fiend challenge, which I read about in one of those lovely facts that we've been using, waiting for us if we were to backtrack. Like, if we go back into this place where we just got done, Rachel just got slapped around. Whoops, did you kill Krogo? Please, we should turn it off. Devil way. Well, I'm glad to know that's there, because now we can use Ninpo, our icy Ninpo, against some enemies and see what that does. What can I do for you? Oh, we'll definitely need... Okay. Well, it's going to cause an extreme rage reaction in the guy who's no longer watching these videos anymore, but if I fully level up this wooden sword, we end up with something called Unlabored Flawlessness. The true form of the wooden sword can... Containing an ethereal sense of weight, its impacts are incredibly powerful. But, now we'll definitely need more cash, because we just spent most of our money. That was, like, more than half of the money that we had left by the time we were done, replacing some of the other stuff that we've been, we actually used some of these for a change. So, yeah, as long as we went to the trouble of getting it and spending $1 million to upgrade it, we should probably use the Unlabored Flawlessness. Biggest problem is anything that like that flying swallow I've become pretty dependent on, especially against bosses. So it doesn't seem like it's gonna be that great for that. Where are you at, Doku? I heard you slapping Rachel around. I'm not gonna stand for it. Oh, this place is looking different. Another devil fiend thing. Dare I? Why not? Incendiary shuriken in his pocket are usable, but no more can be carried. So unfortunately, I kind of screwed that up. Can I get through here without... Yeah, there shouldn't be a replacement death ball, right? Good, we can just kind of casually stroll down the corridor doom now. God damn it, even when you... I guess I was supposed to, Oh, and the pillars are not there because they got destroyed. Yeah, that makes sense, actually. They were destroyed by the rolling ball of doom. Actually, now that I think about it, these spikes should no longer be here. They should have been flattened. So the corridor of doom should actually be completely safe now. Up even worse. I'm trying to get down here for a fiend challenge. I don't want to get like stuck down here permanently. I said I was going to use the ice ninpo before the video is over. But if I get to the point where I'm completely stuck and I need to load, then the game will make a liar out of me. Yeah, there's... I don't understand the jump mechanics well enough. There was, like, a thing on the wall that I thought I could jump and grab. But instead, he does, like, these wooden thing. That wooden thing I thought I could grab or something, but... Instead, he just does a... make it kind of look like you can. Well, maybe there's a. If I can skip up here, sort of kind of. Yeah. Just bring me up back to the level that had the treasure chest, because now I'm really curious what that treasure chest was. guess I did come down here to find... Okay, I know that that treasure chest wasn't, like, something super... I can't remember exactly why I came down here. I thought it was to do a fiend challenge, but... Yeah, there's a fiend challenge down here that I want to get taken care of. Certainly don't seem to be a lot of enemies here, which is not that big of an issue, other than the fact that I could have potentially used this place while I was sipping tea and listening to riff tracks to try to replenish my funds. We can replenish our funds. I have a feeling that there will be plenty of soldiers for us to fight. Oh! Plenty of soldiers for us to fight. Whether we'll be able to maintain getting enough healing items from them in my off-screening that I'm not spending more money than I'm making by fighting. Maybe we'll see. So that whole area is still accessible, but you would drown if you tried to do anything there. Got it. This place had respawning enemies in the previous chapter, but not anymore. I might have to specifically check that fact that said I could had a fiend challenge down here. Because I'm going kind of a ways out of my way here, and not getting much out of it. But now if I attempt to beat the challenge, this video is going to go way longer. Oh, there's an arrow archer dudes over here, I didn't notice. More archer dudes. This is a fun weapon. Let's try using some other stuff here. Save on a different slot in case this turns out to have been a supremely bad idea. point ever going back to chapter one. I don't know why I keep trying to save this. Because if this fiend challenge is not in this, this is the last room I can think of where it would be. So we could do a separate video of that. Let's see if this is the fiend challenge, and if it is, I'll call it a video on the. I guess I'll do one more video. Oh, it is, because I remember specifically they said the ritual room was the location one. Okay, so we've got a fiend challenge in here. Don't know if it's these guys, it probably won't be that bad, but I'm thinking there'll be a mix of these guys and some other dudes as well. So when we come back, folks, we will do that and then manage to hopefully fight our way back out of this place, if it's the last thing we ever do, although I'm not quite sure how to get out of here. No, wait, I was able to get back to that treasure chest, which means I can get back to those platforms to jump across. So we can get out. And we will get out. And then next time, we will do the Fiend Challenge. Hopefully we will win the Fiend Challenge. We will fight our way back up to the surface, and may end up being a slightly short video if I decide to find some place to grind for cash while drinking tea, because I still have not had that cup of tea I've been talking about for several videos, which for you guys, because of the upload rate, you're thinking that I've gone days without having this cup of tea. I've become Arthur Dent.